I am Santosh Gaidankar. Today I am teaching you mechanics of material. In that one, volumetric strain. Volumetric strain is nothing but a member or a structural member subjected to a single force or a system of force undergoes change in all direction, and thereby its volume also changes. Now, the ratio of change in volume to the original volume we call as a volumetric strain, denoted by EV or epsilon V. EV is nothing but change in volume to the original volume. The formula is EV is equal to delta V by V, where delta V called as a change in volume and V is nothing but the initial volume. Now what happens here, when a member is subjected to a tension, if a tension is subjected, then what happened? The length will increases and the width and the thickness will be get reduced. The thickness and width get reduced. That means in the case of thickness and the width, reduction occurs. In the case of length, increase will occur. This is the volumetric strain. Volume, we are considering the volume here. Now, a volumetric strain for rectangular bar subjected to an axial force, that is single axis, axial stress system. Now, this is the diagram. Based on this diagram, we are going to arrive the volumetric strain. Now, it consisting of a rectangular box, the length L, thickness D or depth D, breadth B or width B. Where delta L is nothing but change in length, delta B decrease in width because the tension is applied. As the tension is applied, the length increases, breadth and the width and the thickness or depth get reduced. Delta B is nothing but decrease in the width or depth. Delta D is nothing but decrease in the thickness or depth. It total depends upon the Poisson's ratio. Here the Poisson's ratio comes in picture. Poisson's ratio. Where Poisson's ratio is nothing but Poisson's ratio denoted by mu or 1 by m. It is defined as the lateral strain. Lateral strain by longitudinal strain. Lateral strain by longitudinal strain. Here longitudinal strain is nothing but along the length we call as a longitudinal strain. The lateral strain refers to the depth and the thickness. This is the thickness and this is the depth or breadth or the depth where reduction occurs. Now final length, the final length of the bar, final length of the bar, final length of the bar. Final length of the bar, what happens? L will be increased, L plus delta L. L plus delta L. If final length, what happened? Increases. Now final length in case of width decreases. Final length in case of depth decreases. Final width or breadth of the bar decreases. For breadth, I have taken B here. B minus delta B. Final depth or thickness of the bar D minus delta D. D minus delta D. Now initial volume of the bar V is nothing but L B D. It is a rectangular section. Initial volume L B D, volume of the section. The final volume, similarly, the final volume will be, multiply this one, L plus delta L, B minus delta B, D minus delta D, delta D, D minus delta D. Now multiply here, first I will going to multiply these two. एल बी, नेक्स्ट माइनस एल डेल्टा बी प्लस बी एल डेल्टा एल माइनस डेल्टा एल डेल्टा बी डी माइनस डेल्टा डी मल्टीप्लाई है. नाउ फर्स्ट आई विल मल्टीप्लाई डी एल बी डी माइनस एल डी डेल्टा बी प्लस बी डी डेल्टा एल माइनस डी डेल्टा एल डेल्टा बी. नाउ दिस टर्म आई विल मल्टीप्लाई माइनस एल बी डेल्टा डी नेक्स्ट प्लस एल बी माइनस बी डेल्टा एल डेल्टा डी प्लस डेल्टा एल डेल्टा बी डेल्टा डी. नेग्लेक्टिंग द प्रोडक्ट, neglecting the product, this is the product, neglecting the product, this is also product, this is also get product, this is also product, we have to neglect it, neglecting the product, because if you multiply the smallest value with the smallest, then it will going to be again the smallest value, therefore you have to neglect that one. Neglecting the product. Smaller value has to be neglected. L B D minus, first I will consider positive, B D delta L minus L B delta D minus L D delta B. Delta. Now change in volume. Change in volume. Delta is nothing but final volume. Final volume minus initial volume. Final volume. Write the final volume. L B D plus D minus L B delta D. Minus LD delta B. Initial volume. This is the initial volume. LBD. This and this get cancelled. Further, it can be written as BD delta L minus LB delta D minus LD delta B. This is a change in volume. We know that. Volumetric strain is nothing but EV is equal to delta V by V. Now delta V is nothing but BD delta L minus LB delta D minus LD delta B divided by V initial volume LBD. I'm going to split this form. EV is equal to BD delta L divided by LBD minus LB delta D divided by LBD minus LD delta B divided by LBD. BD, BD get cancelled. Delta B, L, B get cancelled. LD, LD get cancelled. And further it can be written as EV is equal to delta L divided by L minus delta D divided by D minus delta B divided by B. B. However, delta L by L we referred as a longitudinal strain, and delta D divided by D, delta B divided by P, we are referring as a lateral strain. Lateral strain. From the diagrams here, this part I am going to refer as a longitudinal strain. Breadth and depth we are going to refer as a lateral strain, because the decrease occurs. As the decrease occurs, the Poisson ratio comes in picture. Further, it can be written as EV is equal to delta L by L minus 2 delta B by B. Because both are equal, it becomes 2 delta B by B. Now, the volumetric strain EV, now this part is called as a longitudinal strain. Longitudinal strain minus 2 into lateral strain. 2 into lateral strain. We know that Poisson's ratio mu or 1 by m is nothing but lateral strain divided by longitudinal strain. Longitudinal strain. Now here, I'm going to write in terms of longitudinal strain. Longitudinal strain is equal to lateral strain the longitudinal strain, okay, I will cross multiply it. It becomes longitudinal strain divided by m. Now lateral strain is nothing but longitudinal strain divided by m, or longitudinal strain into mu. You can write mu here, into mu. Now, in place of lateral strain, I am going to substitute this one. EV is equal to longitudinal strain minus 2 into longitudinal strain divided by m. Longitudinal strain common, it becomes 1 minus 2 divided by m. 1 minus 2 divided by m. Now what is longitudinal strain? The longitudinal strain is nothing but delta L by L 1 by 2 divided by m. It is, you have written it, longitudinal strain is delta L by L. Longitudinal delta L by L. Further, EV is nothing but delta L by L 1 divided by 2 mu, because 1 by m can also be written as mu. Now, what is delta L by L? Strain. EL is nothing but delta L by L, strain. This is the strain. Strain in length, along the length. And we know that stress is proportional to the strain. The stress, sigma is equal to, in order to remove the stress, we'll introduce Young's modulus into strain. Strain is nothing but sigma divided by E. Sigma divided by E. That means, in this formula, EV is equal to EL 1 minus 2 mu. Now replace with EL, with this term, EV is equal to sigma divided by E 1 minus 2 mu. 1 minus 2 mu. because this is EL. This is EL. Strain is nothing but change in length divided by original length. One more formula for finding the strain. Stress is proportional to the strain. Stress is equal to Young's modulus divided into strain. The strain is nothing but stress divided by Young's modulus. Now substitute in place of EL, E sigma divided by E. This is the volumetric strain. This is the volumetric strain for rectangular bar when subjected to a single force. When it's subjected to a single force. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.